7. And it starts off, who has believed our report? And to whom has the arm of the Lord been revealed? For he shall grow up before him as a tender plant and as a root out of dry ground. He has no form or comeliness, and when we see him, there is no beauty that we should desire him. He is despised and rejected by men, a man of sorrows and acquainted with grief. And we hid, as it were, our faces from him. He was despised, and we did not esteem him. Surely he has borne our griefs and carried our sorrows, yet we esteemed him stricken, smitten by God and afflicted. But he was wounded for our transgressions. Woo! He was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement of our peace was upon him, and by his stripes we are healed. All we like sheep have gone astray. We have turned everyone to his own way, and the Lord has laid on him the iniquity of us all. He was oppressed and he was afflicted, yet he opened not his mouth. He was led as a lamb to the slaughter, and as a sheep before his shearers is silent, so he opened not his mouth. Father, we thank you, Lord, for your word. Let's go into prayer now. Father, we thank you, Lord, for this time right now, God. We honor you and we praise you, Lord, because you are the true and living God, so worthy to be praised, God. Thank you, Lord, that we are standing on holy ground, Father, and that your angels are all around. Satan, we resist, rebuke you, and denounce you right now in the mighty and matchless name of Jesus. You have to go. Father, we thank you, Lord, for giving us traveling grace and mercy to get here. We thank you for social media, God, that someone can hear your word go forth. You said it will not return unto you void. Thank you, Lord Jesus, because we love you, Father. Thank you for blessing us this day, God, for the activity of our limbs, God. Thank you for giving us a mind stayed on you, Jesus. Worthy is the Lamb, God. Hallelujah to the Lamb of God. Yahweh, we love you, Lord. There's no one like you, Father. We came to praise you and lift you up, God. Because you said if you be lifted up, you'll draw all men unto you, Father. So we give your name the praise, the glory, and the honor in the mighty and matchless name of Jesus, God, as we celebrate you today, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, God. Thank you. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on. Let's worship the Lord today. This is the day the Lord has made. We will rejoice. We will be glad in it. This is the last Sunday in the month of March. March 26th. The time is just flying by. But we give God the glory right now. Oh God, we thank you today for opportunity to worship you in spirit and in truth. Those of you watching us on social media, welcome to Greater Faith Christian Church Worship Experience. Our motto here is, without faith, it is impossible to please the Lord. Are you ready to worship the Lord with me? Are you ready to worship the Lord with me? Well, come on, let's exalt his name together. Yeah. Hey, Lord, you're mighty.
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 Lord, you're mighty. Lord, you're mighty.
Come on, put those blessed hands together. Come on.
Yeah, we serve a mighty God. Yeah, we want the world to know. We serve a mighty God. His name is Jesus Christ. He is the Savior of the world. This is the season we get to celebrate Jesus for what he did for us on Calvary. So let's just worship the Lord and praise him like we want to let him know how we feel about him on today. Oh, I love the Lord. Do you love him? Do you love him?
Yeah.
Yes, I love Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory to your name. Yes, Lord, we praise you today. Hey, 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 Lord, you're mighty.
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 Lord, you're mighty. Lord, you're mighty.
Lord, you're mighty.
Lord, you're mighty.
Lord,
put those blessed
mighty.
Hands together again. Come on. Yeah. Yeah.
Yes, I was glad when they said to me, let us go into the house of the Lord. Yes. Looking forward to this moment to give God the glory. Yes, he's been so good to us. He's been better to us than we've been to ourselves. Yes, let's worship him today. This just might be our last time. We don't know. Yes, let's glorify the Lord. Hallelujah. Glory to your name, O Most High. Hey. 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 Lord, you're mighty.
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 One more time. Put those hands together. Come on.
Of all you made, the sun, the moon.
Lord, you're mighty.
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 This morning. If you need him, give him a hand praise. If he's been good to you, give him a hand praise. Hey, hallelujah. Glory to God. I'm going to say right there, praise is what I do. When I want to be close to you, I lift my hand in praise. Hallelujah. I feel like running. Praise is who I am. Hallelujah. I want to praise him while I can. Every time I say that part right there, I understand what they're saying because I may not be here tomorrow. So I'm going to praise him while I can. I'll bless him at all times. I vow to praise you through the good and the bad. I'll praise you whether I'm happy or sad. I'll praise you Can I do that again, Maestro?
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Praise it when I do. When I want to get close to you, I lift my hands in praise. Hallelujah. Praise is who I am. Every time I get a chance, I want to praise him. Why? I can. How blessed you are all time. I vow to praise you. Yes, I will. Through the good and the bad. Hallelujah. Your spirit will help me. I'll praise you. Whether I'm happy or whether I'm sad, I'll praise you in all that I go through, because I do. And I owe it all to you. Come on, help me sing it. Come on, we all know it. Help me sing it. If I want to be close to you, I lift my hands. I lift my hands in praise. Praise is who I am. I will praise you while I can. I will praise you while I can. I bless you.
on, give the Lord a hand praise. Give the Lord a hand praise. Yeah, Lord. Hallelujah. 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 I'm going to bring this up in the worship experience because this song reminds me of what we should do when we're feeling good or when we're feeling bad. I never realized I understood it, but I never realized that if you had a pet for a long time, when that pet passes away, you are mourning. Anybody know what I'm talking about?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
We had a dog. Now, y'all know our dog, Dixie. Yeah. Everybody knows us, know I talk about Bougie Dixie. How bougie she was because how we spoil her. She used to just walk around like that.
Yeah.
We had Dixie since Lorraine was 6 years old. I would say six because I used to look at what Dixie used to look at Lorraine because Lorraine's so tall right now. Like a couple of weeks ago, I looked at Dixie when Lorraine came home from school one time. Dixie was just looking at Lorraine like, who are you? Where is that little Lorraine that I know that said, Dixie, Dixie? But Dixie's been around us for a long time, y'all. And Tuesday, we did not expect that Dixie was going to pass away. Unexpectedly, Dixie passed away on us. That day was one of those days where she was waiting on Lorraine to come home from school. You could tell because I was there with her. Me and Dixie were buddies. You know, when Lorraine wasn't around or doing anything, I was taking care of Dixie. I've been doing it for years. She was my sleep buddy. She would always sleep right next to me. I got a picture to prove it in my phone right now that everywhere I was, that's where Dixie was, because Dixie know that what I eat, she gonna eat. So she would always follow me around. I look down and she just whip tail just wagging, waiting on me to just say, that brisket we had for Women's Day, Dixie smelled that brisket, Miss Brown. She was losing her mind. I had to say, oh, come on, yeah. So every time the smell, the aroma was in the air, she knew, I'm going to get me some brisket.
Yes.
Tuesday morning, Dixie had a rough morning Tuesday. But for the last couple of weeks, she wasn't really herself. It's like she had a cold, and she was still barking, still running, still eating, still having a good time. Tuesday morning, though, she was slow. Lorraine was like, she didn't have a good morning. She's still in her cage. So we was like, well, that's all right. She'll be all right. She went to school, and it was just me and Dixie because First Lady was in Chicago all last week. So it was just me and her. It was Tuesday. It was cloudy. It was raining. It was one of those dreary days. And I sat there and just watched Dixie. We got a rug in the family room, and she would lay on this end, and then she'll get up and move and lay on that end. It seemed like she was losing her breath, or she was trying to get some air from somewhere. And then she would come, and then she, for the last time, sat next to me and laid there. And of course, you know, I didn't think she was going to pass away. That's just her spot. This is what we do when we chill. And then she got up, and then she sat on the left side of me. Dixie never sat on the left side of me. I should have known then someone right. But you could tell she was waiting till Lorraine came home from school. You could tell she was holding on until she came home from school. I couldn't believe that, because when I sit Tuesday after it was all over with and took inventory on her, I said, this dog was waiting on Lorraine. Because for the last time, because she didn't want to go outside. Usually when it rains, she don't care. She wanted to go out there and do her do and come on, run back in and bark at the door. well, you know, Lorraine's door so Lorraine could let her in. This time she went out there and just laid there to enjoy the rain. And then I looked out there again, she had gone, but she didn't bark that day. So I had to get up to see where she was. And I said, Dixie, and she was at Lorraine's door, peeping at me, trying to see, is she home yet? But I said, no, you can come on in, come on in. So I let her come on in, and she sat there and then went to her, one of her favorite spots is under the table in the kitchen. So when Lorraine came home, she said, where Dixie at? I said, she under the table? She said, no, she not under the table. I said, well, maybe she went back in the room. She went back in the room, and Lorraine went in the room, and she couldn't find Dixie in the room. So I said, well, go on up front, because she's been walking around all day, you know. She went back in the room, and Dixie wasn't in the room, so I went in the room. When I went in the room, it was dark. I don't know why I didn't turn the light on, but I used my flashlight on my phone to look around for her. And there she was. She was right there. And I told Lorraine, here she is right here. So I go out, and Lorraine says, Dad, I don't think she's doing well. I said, well, let's see if we could call a vet or something to see what's going on. Because that's the first time we even suggested a vet for Dixie. Because Dixie never gave us that impression ever that something was wrong with her to a point where we need to call a vet. But when I went into the room to get my ring, because I don't wear my ring around the house, she said, Dad, Dixie collapsed. So Dixie was laid on the side. And that's when Lorraine was still doing her due diligence because I couldn't find no vet on my computer. These young people today, she found a vet on her phone. And she found the right vet because that vet told us to bring her in. I picked her up. We got in the car. I put Dixie in Lorraine's lap. And we drove to the vet. And they treated us like Dixie was a human being. I mean, they was waiting at the door for us and everything, and I just knew it was just going to be something. They revived her. Dixie was coming on home. But they took us to a room in that vet place, and we sat there, and she came in with the saddest look. Lorraine was in there praying and begging, and I told her, you don't have to beg. Just ask the Lord. You know, it's all good, because I have to explain death to everyone, because even the grass dies. Yes. Even the leaves of the trees die. So pets pass away too. And we had Dixie for a long time, and she had Dixie just as long as more than half of her life. And when they came in and said, no, I'm sorry, she didn't make it, that tore me up. Yes. I'm still like in mourning. That's why that song, Praise Is What I Do. Even when it comes down to an animal, y'all get attached to those animals like they are human beings.
Right.
You talk to them just like they're going to talk back.
Yes.
I think about all that. Even when Dottie and them come in, they fell in love with Dixie. Monica, I haven't even told Monica yet. Now, Lord, Monica, I hope you're not watching this worship experience and finding out your Dixie pooed and passed away. Oh, what a way to find out. Please, I hope she's not watching. Because I haven't even called. There's so many people that knew Dixie. But she was just the sweetest dog. And she went home. She went and passed away on us Tuesday. So keep us lifting up, because we're hurting right now. But that song, Praise Is What I Do, through the good and through the bad. Whether you happy or whether you sad. And it doesn't matter what the happiness is or the sadness is. Praise should continually be in my mouth. We that are believers in the body of Christ, y'all got to find a way to shake that off. Shake the mourning off. Shake the anger and the rage and the madness off. And just worship God. But that's what we were made to do. We were made to worship Him. We were made to worship Him. That was our purpose. But I don't know what my purpose is. I know what one purpose is for y'all, to worship God. And when you start worshiping God, then you will feel the presence of the Lord come on you. The Spirit of the Lord will come all on you. You know why? Because first of all, the Spirit of the Lord is already in you.
And what's in you will come out of you. Even when the word of God says, out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaks. The Spirit of the Lord does the same thing. That's why we must fortify our spirit too. We must fortify our spirit man too. So remember that when you're having a hard day. From this point on, have praise on your lips. Praise and worship. Oh, I'm down to my last dime. Hallelujah. Glory to your name. Plant that seed of worship. Oh God, I need a job right now, Lord. Worship God right there. Praise him while you have a chance. Because he's worthy to be praised. Whether you have the job or you don't have the job, you act like you got the job by worshiping God anyhow. But he's taking too long. Worship him anyhow. I'm so excited at Tyrus's testimony. I'm so excited at his testimony because while he was on vacation, he got a call that he got another job. The Lord had blessed him with a job working for the city of Tulsa. And a job that he was doing for a long time. So now he can walk in the door. He's been on vacation all week, y'all. So now he can walk in the door and give his 2-week notice and say, I retired, just so he can go to his new job. How you like that? What a mighty God we serve. Hallelujah. So I said all that to say, if you don't hear anything else, see, it was that communion that messed me up today. Woo, you don't know. I'm ready to preach, and I ain't even preaching today. Woo! What a beautiful display this morning. When you let the Spirit of the Lord use you, you don't know who you blessing. You don't know who you blessing. If you just bless one somebody, then the kingdom of heaven is rejoicing. So you remember that, all right? Can I do a Cain? Nobody, hey, do me like Jesus. Can't nobody do me like the Lord. Can't nobody, hey, do me like Jesus. He's mine. Come on, put those hands together. Come on. Can't nobody, hey, do me like Jesus. Can't nobody. Hey, hey, do me like the Lord. Hey, can't nobody. Hey, do me like Jesus. He's my friend. Hey, can't nobody. Can't nobody. Hey, do me like Jesus. Hey, can't nobody. Hey, do me like the Lord.
I'll see you, little man.
Come on, put those blessed hands together like a little man. Come on. Come on, LeBron.
Come on.
Let's take this time. Let's take this time to fellowship one with another. What a fellowship, what a joy divine. Leaning on the everlasting arms. Come on, let's fellowship. Amen. Come on, give the Lord a hand, praise. Who is? Okay. Amen. Amen. Tyrus, I just want you to know that service in progress is showing up on the board out there. Yes, yeah. We fixed our digital sign, and we had a conference call on Thursday here and helped us and showed us how to finally work that. Tyrus, put service in progress. So everybody driving up and down the street right now, know we in here. They should know us anyway because we loud up in here. We loud. Now we open up the door, y'all know we're loud in here. Glory to God. Hallelujah. It's so good to be in the house of the Lord. You don't understand how I look forward to it. I even had in my head all morning. Y'all know those songs. If I got a song in my head, I got to get it out. And this morning, I kind of held off. I'll probably wait till next Sunday to do it, Chris. I'm going to try and keep that. Next Sunday is Palm Sunday. So I want us to be mindful of next Sunday in the month of April. If it's too hot in here, is it cool enough to open the doors? Okay, well, be careful opening up that door because I don't want no bees to come in. I don't want them getting the Holy Spirit too. So you can open that door too if you want. Say it, talk to me. Oh, okay, excuse me. A presentation, if you will. I assume that. Well, then, let's do the presentation then. You want to do the presentation now? Or is it part of the message? Okay, well, she got to wait. The presentation got to wait. Sorry, because it ain't that time yet. Because this is the last Sunday that we continue to celebrate the month of the woman. Hallelujah. I praise God for women. I don't know where I'd be if I did not like women. Oh, I could go there a lot. I could go a lot of places there. First of all, if it wasn't for a woman, I wouldn't be here. I only want to talk about the men. You know what I'm saying? The men have something to do with it. But the women, I give God the glory because I'm a heterosexual 100% man. And I praise God, I know who I am. I grew up around a lot of women, but not one time did you see me tipping and dipping just because I was around a lot of women. Look, I was doing the total opposite. I was busy. Yeah. I was admiring the scenery. I remember when I was 5 years old, I went to a wedding reception. Oh, my God. At 5 years old, I was just sitting there. Me and my brother and my sister, we were just sitting there. There were so many women there that day. I remember it. I remember it well. Not one time did I want to carry a purse or tip and dip. No, I was looking forward to becoming a man where I can put away childish things. Is that too much information? If it is, too doggone bad. That's what's wrong with the world today. They need to hear that. Man, you know, wish I would have some. You know, you got parents today. You got parents today want to give the child a choice whether they want to be a boy or a girl. The devil is a lie. Then they want to look down at us because we don't want to accept that. No, we don't accept that. We won't accept that. The Word of God talks about so much, and it talks about everything. Everything. Even when it relates to homosexuality. But I need to tell y'all, and I'm going to let Miss Kaya come, that the thief comes to kill, steal, and destroy. But Jesus says, I am come. That you might have life. Kind of well, these two dudes that want to change their gender to be transsexuals, how they gonna bring a baby in this world? And I'm gonna even go a step further. They got these doctors in here trying to do it, trying to make a man have a baby and give him all them pills and shots. And We pray. That's what we do. We pray. Yeah, I stopped talking about them. We pray. If that's the way you want to be, we pray. If that's where you want to go, we pray. Because can't nobody do me like Jesus. Can't nobody do me like the Lord. God can answer your prayer better than you can fix it. He can take care of the problem better than you can. So we continue to be prayerful. Amen. Yay, glory. Hallelujah. Yeah, stop talking about them. Stop talking about them and just pray. And the reason why we have to continue to pray, because I tell them all the time, when the Lord turns you over to a reprobate mind, ain't nothing you can do. You remember King Saul back in the Old Testament? And Samuel said, the Lord has left you. What am I supposed to do? Yeah, the Lord left King Saul. So Saul is on his own. When the Lord turned you over to a reprobate mind, they think they're doing what they want to do. They think they're on their own because they're right. They don't understand that the ruler of the darkness of this world, the spiritual wickedness in the high places, cannot supersede the creator and maker of all mankind. So when the Lord turned you over to a reprobate mind, we pray because we got work to do. We pray because this is how we have to deal with, you know, I was in the, coming out my car in the gas station Thursday, and as soon as I opened the door, some truck was flying by in a gas station, right in the middle, flying, and the guy that worked there, the employee, he said, I'm so sorry, sir. I said, hey, this is the days that we live in right now. He don't have enough sense enough to drive slow because people walking through the gas station like that, and you like that in the gas station? We pray. That's what we do. We pray. And see, I've already had my prayers up already. That's why he didn't touch my door. It shall not come nigh thee. Remember Psalm 91, huh? Did I hear he that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty? I will say of the Lord. At this time, see, it's something about this sacred place here. Let me come down. Come on, Miss Kaya. Come on, give the Lord a hand of praise for Miss Kaya.
I love poetry, so I'm going to be speaking about a poet, Gwendolyn Brooks. Poetry has always been used for people to speak their voice and to give their opinions about things that are going on in the world, from today to when we were fighting slavery and even segregation, so it's beautiful that I can talk about this woman right here. Gwendolyn Brooks was born in 1917 in Topeka, Kansas. Before long, the Great Migration took her family from Topeka to Chicago, and she was a lifelong Chicagoan, residing in the South Side until her death. During her early years, Gwendolyn's family experienced hardship and financial struggles. Brooks began writing poetry as a child and published her first poem in Children's Magazine when she was just 13 years old. She attended four different high schools throughout the city, an all-white high school, an all-black high school, and an integrated high school. She had a unique perspective on race that influenced her work. By the age of 16, Brooks had become prolific, publishing 75 poems. These poems, which included sonnets, ballads, and free verse, were being published in the Chicago Defender, a primarily African-American newspaper. Gwendolyn's work at this time contained a robust description and celebration of inner city life. During this time, she quoted as saying, "I felt that I had to write. Even if I had never been published, I knew that I would go on writing, enjoying it, and experiencing the challenge." She graduated from Wilson Junior College. She married Henry Blakely, and they had two children. Brooks met with James Weldon and Johnston and Langston Hughes, both literary greats, and they urged her to write more and to read more during that time. She was also director of publicity for the NAACP. By 1943, she had earned an award from the Midwest Writers Conference, and a few years later, in 1945, Brooks' first published book, A Street in Bronzeville, earned a Guggenheim Fellowship and several other awards. She later published Annie Allen, which was so well received that it made her the first African American to win the Pulitzer Prize in Literature. She began teaching poetry at a workshop at Columbia College in 1963, after she taught creative writing at a number of universities, including Northeastern Illinois University, Elmhurst College, Columbia University, Clay College of New York, and the University of Wisconsin. Brooks received many awards from the government. She was also invited to the White House by John F. Kennedy to participate in the Liberty of Congress public readings. In 1968, she became the poet Laureate of Illinois. In this role, she created workshops and public readings to make poetry more accessible to everyday people.
Amen. Miss Gwendolyn Brooks. Amen. Bless you, Miss Kaya. I didn't know. When I heard Bronzeville in Chicago, that's where I was born and raised, in Bronzeville. See, you would think they would have told us, it gave us that type of history. You know, Gwendolyn Brooks walked up and down there. I found out the emotions. Remember the emotions? Don't ask my name. They lived right around the corner from me. I ain't even know. Well, Minnie Ripperton, I ain't even know until I met her sister one time, because her sister worked at St. Luke Hospital in Chicago. I even met Minnie Ripperton, bless her heart, a month before she passed away. Boy. It's just something. It's just good to hear history. There's nothing wrong with listening to history every now and then. Amen. I want to say hello to our guests, but before that, I want Miss Kara's sister to say hello to us. A stranger, tell everybody hello and what you've been doing.
Hello, everybody.
Hello.
My name is Desiree, and I actually just got back from being moved in Germany.
Germany.
2 days ago.
Wow. What part of Germany were you in?
I was in Longstuhl, out at the hospital.
Really? How far is that from Munich? Do you know?
Munich. It's about a 3-hour drive.
3-hour drive from Munich.
Yeah.
Wow. How was that experience?
It was fun.
How long were you there?
9 months.
Woo!
Yes.
In Germany for 9 months. You're looking well. How
you
feeling?
I'm feeling good.
Good, good. Family well?
Yes, they are.
Good. It's so good to see you. Grandsons?
Yeah. This is my newest grandson, Dante.
Ooh.
And
you gotta, since you came back, they sticking close to you now, huh?
Yes.
You trying to get all this spoiling in, aren't you?
Yes, they
are. Oh, praise the Lord. Who's this little beautiful one? Oh, Julian. Oh, yeah, I've seen her. Well, God bless you. It's so good to have you come and hang out with us. It's so good to see you. Praise the Lord. Come on, give the Lord a hand of praise for Kara's sister. It's two young ladies, the pain in the back, and sat on the back row. I know you. Hey, you look like Auntie May. Don't she look like Auntie May? Come on, y'all got to tell everybody hello and who you are.
Hello, everybody. My name is Regina Magic. I'm a visitor. My daughter's coming, and this is my girl. I adopted her back in the day.
Really?
I've been knowing her forever.
She knew everybody. Yes. I'm going to start telling you that. You know everybody.
Yeah.
Isn't that something? And that's your mother. Really?
No, she's my mother.
No.
Sometimes she acts like it.
I understand what you're saying. I know exactly what you're saying.
But
she
so
trying to run things. She don't know, though, do she?
I know. But so far, I'm enjoying myself. I've heard about you. I just had a chance to come and check you out.
Bless your heart. Now, are you visiting from out of the valley?
No, I've been here since 2020 from Florida.
From Florida?
But I'm actually a resident here. Then I retired and thought, okay, when you retire, you go to Florida and hang by the beach.
Uh-huh.
The alligators and I didn't do too much.
I know that's right. I know that's right. I'd rather be in the heat than to be chased by alligators.
On the beach.
I know that's right. God bless you. Thank you so much for coming. You don't tell everybody your name anyway, Mama.
Renata.
Renata.
Yeah, Magic.
It's so good to see you again.
Yeah, you too.
Hanging out. What you messing with Mama for? Leave Mama alone. Let her do what she want to do. She retired.
No, you cannot.
No. Now, is this your only child? Uh-huh. And five children. Bless your heart. And you look good, too. They keep you going, don't they? They keep you young. Come on. I know that's right. Amen. Well, you looking well, praise the Lord. God is taking good care of you and your daughter.
Yeah,
Come on, give them.
I'm 76 years old.
Ooh-wee, she's 76 years young. I hope when I'm here at 76, I'll look that young. Come on, give the Lord a hand, praise to mama and daughter. Well, you from Chicago? What part? No. What part?
West side.
Ooh. You know any Blands on the west side? Did you know any Blands or Pools or Francis?
I don't know about
everything. Oh, okay.
Oh, yeah.
So you was all over, huh? Uh-huh. And then you went to Florida. What part of Florida? Miami? Okay. Fort Lauderdale, yeah, that's why me and my wife's first experience when we went to Florida was Fort Lauderdale in 1996, and that's how we wound up here. You know how we wound up here? Because I was walking on Lake Michigan during Thanksgiving week, because our anniversary is that weekend. That's why we went, because we were going to cruise to the Bahamas, but we hung out in Fort Lauderdale Thanksgiving Day. That morning, I'm walking on the beach and said, Lord, because the weather was beautiful. You know the weather was beautiful, and when we left Chicago, it was snowing and 30 degrees. And I said, Lord, I would love to live in a place like this. It wasn't even a full year. It was 2 months later, the wife came and called me up and said, how would you like to live in Arizona? No. She said, how would you like to live in Phoenix? That's what she said. I said, Arizona? She's like, yeah. I said, I got to answer you right now. She said, no. I said, I'll tell you what. When you get home, we're going to pray about this thing. And if it's God's will, we going to Arizona. And as you see, it was the will of the Lord. And here we are. Praise the Lord. Man, LeBrock, what's up, man? What's up, man? Tell everybody your name and pass the mic down.
My name is Alex.
Alex.
My name is Alex Sr.
Alex Sr. So you Alex, you AJ then.
I'm Selena.
Hold on. I was talking. What's your name?
Selena.
I like her name. That's why I want y'all to hear her name. Selena.
I'm Marisa.
Marisa.
Arisa.
I got you. Beautiful family we met on Women's Day. Met little man too. When I got him the first time, Maria, that's the daughter, the mama. Did I say the name right? Alisa. Charge it to my head and not my heart. Will you do that? She had this beautiful little man in her arms, and of course, you know I love children, so I tried to grab him the first time. He wasn't having it. I told her the second time, he ain't gonna come back. And that's just what happened. He's just the happiest little man. It's just good to see you all. They gonna be family, and they already family. They just don't know it. I think they know it now, don't they? So good to see y'all. Come on, just give the Lord a hand praise this morning. It's time for the word, but before that, it was down at the cross where my Savior died. Downward from cleansing from sin I cried. There to my heart was the blood applied. I'm singing glory to his name. I'm singing glory. I'm singing glory to his name. I'm singing glory to his name. Precious name, I'm singing glory to his name. Hey, there to my heart was the blood applied. I'm singing glory to his name. Now, help me out. Everybody, put those hands together. Come on. Thank you. precious name I'm singing. Glory to his name. Hey there to my heart. What a blood of light I'm singing. Glory to his name. Glory to his name. Precious name I'm singing. Glory to his name. Hey there to my heart. What a blood of light I'm singing. Glory to his name. Amen. 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 I am so excited to find out who you are. Because this young man has been blessing me this morning. He came in clapping, having a good time, and a child shall lead them. He was having a good time. So I know he got some spirit in him. I know he do. Charmaine, well, then again, tell everybody your name, little man.
I'm Anthony Warren.
Anthony Warren, he even got a, not ashamed of his game either. Anthony Warren, man, it's a pleasure to meet you.
It's a pleasure to meet you, too.
How are you doing? You doing all right?
Yes.
How old are you?
I'm 8 years old.
8 years old. Wow, wow. You on spring break this week, or did you have it last week?
Last week.
It was last week? So that means you got to go back to school tomorrow. Did you have fun last week?
Yes.
You like going to school?
Yes.
Okay, cool, cool, because I don't. I didn't. I'm glad. Tell everybody your name.
I'm Zari.
Huh?
I'm Zari.
Zaria or Zari?
Zari.
Just Zari.
Yes.
Cool. Hey, Zari, how you doing?
I'm good.
Yeah, just the sweetest children. Oh, bless the Lord. How old are you?
I'm 9 years old.
You're 9 years old? You be taking care of Sister AJ? Oh, she take care of you? Oh, cool. Nice, sister. Oh, bless the Lord. Let's give the Lord a hand of praise for this beautiful family. It's good to meet you, man. And young lady. Amen. Praise the Lord. It's time for the word of God. I am so excited to present to some and introduce to others a young lady who's on fire for Jesus. I know she's going to come in and say, who are you talking about? But when you led by the Spirit of the Lord will make you look good. We came in this morning with a display of what she did. I'm not going to even say what she did because it might be part of her message. And if she don't, I'll say it afterwards. But it's just an honor just to know her. What I love about Jesus is we started off on the wrong foot, Minister Diana Kurtz and I. But we had to meet together, and in the meeting, she was, oh, wow, wow. But now we got love for each other like never before. That's the way it's supposed to be, amen? If you got an alt with your brother, you're supposed to go to that person, right? Yeah, that's what you're supposed to do in the spirit of Christ. You know, that's how we're supposed to be as believers. You're not supposed to be walking around there holding no grudges against somebody in God's house. Come on, the devil is alive. We're supposed to love each other. Yeah, me and First Lady, we've been together 31 years. We've been married 30 years. We've had some good days and some bad days. Y'all think she nice. She ain't nice. She mean all the time. Y'all just think she nice because she come in there, ooh, beautiful smile and all that. And I be at the house going, argh. And because of that, we still together. So if she was that, I'd have been gone. But she one of them ones that you ain't going nowhere. Sometimes you got to have a relationship like that. You know, no. If anybody hitting, she the one hitting. I ain't hitting. I ain't never touched her. I'm in church, so I ain't lying. There she is. She'll tell you. You don't see me coming in here with no black eye. Because she fight back. I said all that to say, yeah, y'all better fight back, women. Don't you dare stand there. Oh, Don't you dare stand there. And if you can't fight, just walk. And don't deal with that mess no more. Do you hear what I'm saying? Let him go. Let him mess with somebody else. No, 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 no. I am a woman of God. Say, I love you, precious woman. Who could find a virtuous woman? Look at all you ladies in here. Put your hand on your chest and say, I'm a virtuous woman. Come on, Lorraine, all of y'all, all you females, put your hand on your chest and say, I'm a virtuous woman. I don't care how old you are, 9 years old, there you go. I'm a virtuous woman. Glory to God. Amen. And you remember that. Family, we pray that the Lord will send our daughters men after God's own heart. Men that loved them like Christ loved the church and gave himself for it. Men that will die for them. Men that love them so much that they will sacrifice everything they can for your daughter. That's what prayers is all about right now. Don't wait till you see some old knucklehead come. What's up, mama? Mama, I hit you in your throat. That's right. No, my name is, and tell them. And pull those pants up, doggone it. Oh, I talk to my daughter all the time. She know who to bring around me and who not to bring. I will slam the door in your face, James Evans. Glory to God. I love this woman. I love her with all my heart, just like I love you all. When she gets to give us the word for the day, I present to some and introduce to others, Minister Diana Kurtz. Give the Lord a hand, praise, as she comes in her own way. Amen. Be prayerful, will you? Do she need a mic? Guess not.
Enter into your courts with thanksgiving and enter your courts with praise. Be thankful unto you. So God, I come thanking you this morning, Father God. But Lord God, I come lifting up my burdens to you today, oh God. Hallelujah. Oh God, I'm praying for my people. I'm praying for my people, oh God. Lord, I got a family, oh God. Oh God, my family, my sisters, Lord. My brothers, Lord. My mother, Lord, they don't know how to act, oh God, and I'm leaving them to you, Lord God. I'm asking you to take control, oh God. Keep them, Lord God, in the name of Jesus. I'm just giving them to you today, oh God. Take them, Lord. Take them, Lord. Take them, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Glory to your name, oh God. And Lord God, I'm praying for my husband this morning. I'm lifting him up to you, oh God. That man that you gave me, Lord, hallelujah, hallelujah. I can't do nothing with him, Lord, but I'm asking you, oh God, that you take care of him, oh God. Speak to his heart, oh God. Speak to his mind, oh God. Deliver him, oh God. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. And Lord, I'm praying for my children, Lord. I'm lifting them up to you, Lord. I'm giving them to you, oh God. Hallelujah. Take care of my children, Lord. I got a son that's in jail, Lord God. Hallelujah. My daughter's pregnant. Oh God, touch them right now in the name of Jesus. I didn't bring them up that way, Lord. Hallelujah. But they chose the wrong path. So, Lord, I'm asking you to save them, Lord. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Lord, I'm praying for this old job that you put me on. Hallelujah. I'm asking you, oh Lord, to just take them, oh God. The supervisor don't want to do right today, Lord God. Giving me all this work to do, Father God. Hallelujah. Keeping me late, Lord. And they don't want to pay me. Lord God, hallelujah. I have to work as unto you, oh God. So, Lord God, as I give this work to you, oh God, I'm asking you to bless, Lord God. And Lord God, this car that you gave me, I have a car that don't work, Lord. It's not working, Father God. And I need you to send me a mechanic, oh God. In the name of Jesus. Father God, I give this all to you in the name of Jesus. I ask you to bless right now, Father God. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Bless your name, oh God. Thank you for your grace. Thank you for your mercy. Thank you, Lord, for deliverance, oh God. Thank you for lifting, oh God. You've lifted my weight off of me, oh God. So right now, Lord, I thank you. Lord, I'm so glad. I feel light. I feel good. Lord, now I thank you. I'm feeling better now, Lord. I think I can make it. I think I can go on. I feel like going on, oh God. Going on, oh God. Thank you for lifting. Thank you for lifting. Thank you for the power, oh God. Thank you, Father God. I thank you for deliverance. I give you the praise today, Father God. Yeah. Now bless these your people. Yeah. As I go forth, oh Heavenly Father, yeah. I ask you to bless right now in Jesus' name. Yeah. The load is lighter, my sister. Yeah. The load is lighter. Yeah. I can do better. Yeah. Hallelujah. Yeah. Bless the name of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. I'm so grateful this morning to be in the house of the Lord. Thanking him for all things. Praise the name of the Lord. That tired me out. Praise the name of the Lord. All right, thank you. Thank you. The Lord is good. I thank God for the privilege giving honor to the pastors of this house. The angels of this house, to Pastor and Sister Bland, First Lady Bland, I want to give you praise and thanking God for you for allowing me to stand this morning. It's been a long time since I stood in this position. But you know what? Sometimes the Lord will shut your mouth until he wants you to speak again. Hallelujah. There's some things that we got to go through. Hallelujah. In order for us to stand before the presence of God to speak his oracles. To all of my fellow yokemen in the gospel, Sister Solomon, my sister, God bless you. It feels good to have those who are praying for you standing around you and urging you on for this, for the month of March. We had our own Sister Bland stand on the first Sunday. She stood before us as a pastor and a teacher. Hallelujah.
And then on the second Sunday, we had our own sister standing with us. And she, her ministry is the street ministry. And I know once her and Sister Regina get together, it's going to be a powerful ministry. Amen. Amen. So I'm looking forward to it. Sister Solomon spoke on last Sunday, gave us a blessed message, walking with the Lord. Are we going to walk with the Lord? Hallelujah. Her ministry is uplifting. Praise the name of the Lord. She is an encourager, and she encourages you to walk with the Lord. And now the Lord has given me my ministry, and that is the ministry for the church. My calling is to the people of God in the church. Praise the name of the Lord. The Lord has not changed. Nothing that he has said has changed. He's the same God yesterday as he was, as he is today. There's nothing changed. We have changed, and we're trying to make him change. But the God I serve is steadfast in what he does. Hallelujah. No man can change him. Nothing that we can do can change him. Hallelujah. And so I'm giving God the praise this morning. And my message was, when I last spoke, repent, for the Lord is at hand. I have the same message today. Repent. Repent. Because the Lord is at hand. Amen. Hallelujah. Our lesson is coming from a very familiar scripture. One that we speak so much so until it doesn't even make sense to us anymore. Amen. But it's coming from 2 Chronicles, the 7th chapter and the 14th verse. If my people, who are called by my name, will humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then will I hear from heaven and heal their land. If you, I will. The Lord gave me that topic. He said, if you, I will. If is one of those smallest words in the English language, but it holds great stature and a lot of weight. I forms a lot of words, but standing alone is singular, and its meaning, self, or oneself. In the book of Chronicles, 2 Chronicles, we find Solomon reigning in a position as king of Israel after the death of his father David. He was fulfilling the promise that God had made to his father David. Solomon kept the way of the Lord that his father had taught him. And Solomon went up to the altar before the Lord and offered 1,000 burnt offerings upon it. And in the night, God appeared to Solomon and said to him, ask, what shall I give you? And Solomon said unto the Lord, you have shown great mercy to my father, David, and has made me reign in his stead. Now, O Lord, let your promise to my father be established. Give me now wisdom and knowledge that I may go out and come in among your people.
God said, because this was in your heart, and you did not ask for riches or wealth or honor, wisdom is granted. In the third chapter, we find Solomon beginning to build the temple of the house of the Lord that David himself had wanted to build. But the Lord told him that you will not build the temple. It's good that it's in your heart, but you will not build it. Your son will build the temple. And David began to build the temple of the Lord. And all the things that Solomon began to build the temple. And all the things that David, his father, had dedicated, silver and gold, all the instruments, and the Ark of the Covenant. Solomon began to gather the elders and the priests and the Levites and the people of God, praising God and thanking him and glory to the Lord, giving glory to him. And the glory of the Lord began to fill the house. When David had finished praying, David, as people were coming, he began to pray for the assembly of God's people. And when Solomon finished praying, fire came down from heaven and consumed all the burnt offerings and sacrifices that the Lord had, that they had for the Lord, and the glory of God filled the temple. After all the festivities was over, and the temple had been finished and completed, the Lord appeared and said to Solomon, I have heard your prayer. Solomon had begun to pray for the people, and he was giving the Lord all kinds of scenarios concerning their sins. And if they do this, Lord God, would you hear? If they come to you and ask for forgiveness, would you hear? And I counted, it was 8 scenarios of the type of sins that the people could commit. And he began to ask the Lord, if they came to you and bowed down before you, would you then hear? And the Lord appeared to Solomon. And he said, I have heard your prayer and have chosen this place for myself. He said, if I shut the sky so that there is no rain, if I command grasshoppers to devour the countryside, if I send an epidemic among my people, he said, however, if my people, God is making a proclamation right now to the people of God. He's made a proclamation to God's people. And he said, if my people would humble themselves, I want you to stick a pin in themselves. But let's talk about humble. Humble is a walk in humility. It is not a weakness. It is a sign of strength. So when we begin to humble ourselves before God, when we begin to bow down before God, it does not mean that I am weak. and I'm expecting him, it means that I have submitted to him. Bowing down before God is an act of submission. Recognizing God for who he is. Knowing that I cannot do it without his help. And God is calling for his people to humble. And then he said, themselves. Solomon had gone before the Lord for God's people. But God gave me this revelation. He said, I realized that Solomon was praying for the people of God. But I want the people of God to come to me. Themselves. For themselves. I went, was caught up in the spirit. I'm not going to say I was caught up. But my mind was elevated. And I want you to bear with me for a minute, Pastor. I want you to stand, if you will. And this is what I saw in the spirit. Face toward the east, please. Pastor T, would you stand and hug your husband? Put your arms around your husband. And look to the hills, Pastor. Look to the hills. This is what I saw. The man of God standing in your stead for God. We walk in here and we do our thing. Everybody got their own little thing to do. They come when they wanna. They go when they wanna. They walking in all kind of sin. We saying what we wanna say. We do what we wanna do. And God is not pleased. You got a man of God and a woman of God. For the scripture says they become one. They are standing in your stead, asking the Lord to have mercy upon you. But the Lord calling you to come for yourself. You may kiss your wife, Pastor, and you may be seated. Praise the Lord. All right now. Praise the name of the Lord. Amen. That's the beauty of love. Amen. Praise God. The Lord is calling us to a different standard. He's calling us to bow down before him. We have an altar here. I remember when we were looking for a church, and the first church that I saw, that I went into, I didn't go to all the churches that they had, but the one that I did go to, that first church, I didn't like it when I saw it. I'm like, oh, no, Lord. Praise the Lord. But I didn't have no say-so over it. But I was saying, it was a beautiful edifice. But I wasn't happy with it. And I told the Lord, I said, Lord, I came to the Lord. I went to the Lord on my own. And I began to pray. And I asked the Lord, I said, Lord, the church that we get, I'm praying that an altar will be built in with it, where the people of God can come and bow down before you, oh God. And when I walked into this place, the first thing I saw was an altar. And I said, Father, I thank you because you have heard my cry. This altar is not for flowers. It's not for things to be up on it. But I can understand, because ain't nobody using it. But God is calling for us to bow before him. And you got soft padding that you can bow down before the Lord. There are times when we as people, we want the pastor to pray for us, and we want Pastor T to lay hands on us and pray for us. But the Lord said, if my people will humble themselves, that means that we are to come and bow down before him and surrender ourselves to him and give him the just that he deserves, recognizing him as who he is and allowing him to work things out for us. As I walked in with all of that luggage, with all of that baggage, that's how the children and the people of God are walking every Sunday. They walk into this building. They're heavy with their burdens. They're pretending that everything is all right when they've been carrying these burdens, some of them for years and years and years. And we will not humble ourselves before God and ask the Lord for help. And the Lord is calling for us. Nothing's going to happen until the people of God see their sin and begin to walk and confess and repent unto the Lord and give unto God his due diligence. There will nothing be done until we move in that stature. The Lord is calling for us to walk as we should be walking in the power and the might of the Holy Spirit. When we come before God, the Lord says, when we come before him, humble yourselves in the state of humility, not in the state of shame, for you have nothing to be shameful for in the presence of the Lord. The Lord knows you. He knows all of your problems. He knows all of your cares. But he said to humble yourselves, and he said, pray. Talk to me. Talk to me. I want you to talk to me. I want to hear all that you're going through, all that you've been through. I already know, but it's okay. I want to know how you feel about it. Talk to me. The Lord is calling for us to talk to him and to give everything that we got. Give it all to the Lord. Stop holding on to those things. There were some things that I had been holding on to for years. And it was one minister right here that came and he prayed, and I walked up for prayer. And he said, you got stuff that you've been holding on for years, and you need to let it go. Hallelujah. And I got a chance to begin to let it go. Had a chance to go ahead and forgive those that have hurt me. Hallelujah. We got a lot of unforgiveness. We do not want to talk to nobody. I don't want to see her. I don't want to hear from her. That's not what the Lord is saying to us. You have been bought with a price. You have been called for a purpose, and the Lord desires that of you. Hallelujah. God is so good. He said, humble yourself and pray and seek my face. In Matthew 11, 2 and 11, the scripture says, and when the wise men saw him,
the baby Jesus. They fell down and worshiped him because they had seen the face of God. And there's another saying that says, and wise men still seek him. We will find the face of God in our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Because he said in his word, if you have seen me, you have seen the Father. And the Lord is calling us as people of God to seek his face in every situation, in every trial, in everything that we do. Seek the face of God, that God can be glorified. Hallelujah. We are here to glorify God. We've been called to glorify God. Hallelujah. God is good. He said to seek his face. And he said to turn. There is so much going on in the church today. I heard a minister say not long ago, I was listening to a sermon, and he said, if the Lord was to come today, he wouldn't even know the church. And I said, well, I don't know about you, but I think God knows everything. And he knows what's going on in the church. But I could understand where he was coming from, because we have allowed so much to go on in the church of God. When the Lord said that no adulterers or fornicators shall enter into the kingdom, he meant that. But yet we as a church, we allow these people to come in and to live any old kind of way, to walk in it. And they not only, but they flaunt it. They flaunt it before God. And we sit here and we allow them to do those things. God is not pleased. He did say, come as you are. Yes, you come as you are, but you don't stay that way. You do not stay that way. I went to a church, and I hate to say this, but I'm going to say it anyway. I went to a church, and they had what they called a hat day. And the women were wearing hats, all of these hats, all this stuff. And so I'm sitting in the back because I didn't know what was going to happen. So I just wanted to know what was going on. I didn't know it was hat day that particular day. But I had gone and I sat and I was sitting in the back of the church. And all these women walking in with these hats. I mean, some of them so big you couldn't even see their face, you know. And I'm like, wow, what's going on here? I mean, you know, I hate to sit behind that woman that got that big old hat, because I wouldn't be able to see nothing. But this woman walked in and it was doing praise and worship. And she had a hat that was like a sun hat. It flopped in the front. And she was walking, and her dress was up to here. And when she walked in, the men didn't see her until she passed. But when she passed, I was looking at the men. I don't know if they were married or not. But I was watching them. And they had stopped praise and worship, watching this woman walk down the aisle. Young ladies, I just want to say this to you. Not everybody in the church is saved. And the scripture tells us to dress as becoming saints. So sometimes the way that we dress is a bit extravagant for the church of God. So we need to watch what we wear, because you may be coming for one thing, but some other people, they may be coming for something else.
And I was always taught that you dress in a manner that will cause men to guess at what you got. Not to show everything that you got, but to guess at it. And to them, you are beautiful. To them, you are beautiful. But when they can see everything you got, amen. Amen. But I'm just trying to tell you that we are a growing church. And some things are allowed, and we allow them to come in. But until you get into the Word of God and you study and you begin to see the face of Jesus, that's when you will begin to grow and you will begin to see the face of God. And you will begin to get, the Holy Spirit will bring a feeling over you. And you'll know when you're wearing something that it ain't right. And you'll begin to want to cover yourself. Put on some clothes and to believe and to know. I mean, I'm still cute no matter what. Praise God. We are to dress as becoming saints. Everything cannot be worn to the church. And so we must be expedient in that. So I said, Lord, I don't know why you gave me this one, you know. But I am called to the church, to the people of God. And we must stand in the righteousness of Jesus Christ, because the whole world is listening and the whole world is looking. As I was bowed down before the Lord showed me this church, and you saw the picture of the pastor and his wife standing with his eyes toward the hills, praying for the church of God. And all of a sudden, a beacon light came over the church. And it was so bright till I couldn't even see. It was so bright. And the Lord said, this church will be set up on a hill. And they will be a beacon light unto not only Phoenix, but to the world. We got work to do, church. And we got to get right so we can go home. We've got to stop accepting everything and anything. We can't wear and do everything. The Lord said, come out from among them and be ye separated. We are set apart and set aside for the gospel of Jesus Christ. We will be an example unto all the churches. Am I speaking prophecy today? Hallelujah. This is what God gave me. This church right here will be a beacon light unto all of Phoenix. And not only to all of Phoenix, but to all of the world. And the Lord said, this is my temple. When I walked in and saw all the beauty of the wood, and I could imagine what the temple of God somewhat looked like, because the temple that Solomon built, it was gold, silver. He used the best of the wood, and he built that. And he said, this is the place where God will dwell. Even though we can't put him in a box or in a temple. But the Lord did move in. He moved in. He stuck his foot down in there. Praise God. and it filled the temple. Yeah. Amen. Amen. And they felt his presence. We are only on the surface of praise. I see where you want to go, Pastor, but we're just on the surface. The Lord wants to take us deeper. He said, yes, this is my temple, and I will dwell here. But this is God's temple, the temple of the Lord Jesus Christ. Just as David dedicated things to the church, Christ has dedicated to us his blood. And his blood is up on the doorpost of my heart. Hallelujah. And I've got to live and walk as though Christ liveth within me, that he controls me, that he talks to me, that he walks with me, and that he tells me, as the song said, that I am his own. Hallelujah. I got a lot to give to the Lord, a lot to give. But Christ gave his life for this temple. This is the temple of the Holy Ghost. And you've got to know there's got to be a cleansing. You've got to let all of that stuff go. You can't live there in that mush and dirt and filth. The Lord is calling us to a deeper place in him and a deeper walk in him. And I'm saying to you, as God's people, he said, if my people who are called by my name will humble themselves. And this is the place where God wants us to humble ourselves. When we walk into the temple of God, we bow before him. We have gotten so straight that we just come before the Lord with anything. Just walking up here and call ourselves, we finna pray. Ain't consulted God about nothing. Just coming up in here, he said, well, to enter his gates with thanksgiving and unto his, but he didn't say come with an attitude. The only attitude that you should have is one of praise. I had a Sunday school teacher when we walked into the class. The first thing she would say to us was, attitude check. Praise the Lord. Attitude check. She would get angry with it if you didn't say what she say she wanted you needed to say. And you said it with vigor and glad to say it. Because the more that you say it, the better you'll feel. When you begin to praise God and to lift up the name of Jesus, all of that weight, all of those things that I carried in here, all of that, your family, your loved ones, and all the drama that you're having with your girlfriend, and all of that kind of stuff will be lifted up off of you because you are giving God his due diligence. And the Lord is calling us. He said, there is more that I require of you. I don't know, Silas, do you have that song for me? I know Regina, I had to call Regina to ask her because I wanted to talk to him. But the Lord is calling us to a place of true worship and to praise. The Lord desires to hear from us. He desires us to bow down before him. He's calling us to a disposition of praise. And when we bow down before him, we automatically, if it's in us, prayer will begin to flow. We won't have to ask nobody to pray. We'll be coming out with prayer and praise before God. And if you continue to stay down there, Then the scripture said that with the wise men, he said, when they bowed down before them, they had gifts. And their gift, your gift will be opened. We say we don't know what our gifts are. I dare you to bow down before God. Bow down before God, and he will let you know just what your gift is. And every gift that we have is for the edification of the church. It is for the edification of the church. When we bow down before God, the pastor won't have to ask you to dance. It'll come automatically. Because of the joy of the Lord. You won't need no music, even though we praise God for it, because he's a blessing, and we love you. But when we truly praise God, we don't have to have no music. You know, we'll have that jungle beat, and all of a sudden, everybody's just jumping and jumping and jumping. There ain't no nothing, ain't no confession of sin, ain't nothing. We just jumping because the music is jumping. And there we go, just praising, call ourselves praising God and just lifting. But we're only going by the jungle beat, because you know what? As soon as the music stops, then we stop. Praise the name of the Lord. But when the Spirit of God is truly on you, you're going to dance whether there's music or not. You're going to get that beat, honey, and you're going to be just a dancing and giving God the praise and thanking him for all things and just giving him the glory. Praise the name of the Lord. Even though the music helps, if it's for real, it's going to come out. God is calling us to a different beat, the beat of the Holy Spirit. The Lord said, there is more that I require of you. Are we willing to say yes to the Lord? Are we willing to bow down before him? He is saying to us today that it's a sign of surrenderance. Some of you right now are heavy with the burdens and cares of this world, the burden and cares of this life. Your bills are due, and ain't no money in the bank. Your car needs fixing, and I ain't got no money to fix it. Praise the name of the Lord. There's so much going on. There's so much drama in this world. I get behind people, or they get behind me, rather, when I'm driving, and they just cuss me out. And I just move right on over and let them go right on by. I don't have no qualms with you. I'm happy that you're still alive. Amen. Because you may not stay that way the way you're driving. So I'm giving you an opportunity to live. So I'm going to move over so that you can have that spot that I was in. Come to find out, I'll see him at the next light. All of that running, all of that pushing, all of that honking, all of that, and I still see you. I know one day I was at work, I was driving one of our vans, and I was driving, and I was in the slow lane. He was just honking at me, telling me to move out the way. Get on, do what you got to do. I kept right on at 35 miles an hour, doing my little thing. He passed by me and he drove on off. Got to the next light. He was right there. And I took my horn and I went, bub, bub. And I waved at him. Oh, that man was so mad. When the light turned green, he took off. I mean, he took off. That's the way it is in this world. They ready. But the Lord is saying to you,
Are you really ready to give what God has for you? Are you ready to receive it? If anyone would like to come and bow before the Lord, the altar is open to receive you because God wants to hear from you. He told Solomon, if my people who are called by my name will humble themselves, it's good that you've come before me pleading for your people. And I'm sure he's telling the pastor the same thing. It's good that you come before me and plead for your people. But I want to hear from them. I want to hear from you. I want you to talk to me. I'm not hard to talk to. Talk to me. Tell me what you feel, what you think, what's going on in your life. Hallelujah. Don't be ashamed to come before the Lord. The Lord is calling you right now to come before him and bow before him. I don't understand, but it's something that God desires. And this church, it's going to start with this church. We have to learn to bow before God. Before others can learn, we've got to learn. And we've got to say yes to the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. The Lord desires for you to bow before him and surrender yourself unto him. Don't be ashamed. Don't be afraid. We all got something to go to God before. Our children, our husbands, our wives, our families, our loved ones, our mothers and our sisters, our brothers. We got our jobs. There was a sickness coming before him and giving it to the Lord. And I'm just going to ask the ministers of God not to pray with them, but to stand with them and praise God with them. Hallelujah. Oh, we give God the praise. Thank you, Lord. Praise your name, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. We give your name the praise, oh, Father. We thank you for your grace and your mercy. Father, I come and I surrender myself before you, oh, God. I surrender myself before you, oh, God. Let's bow before the Lord. Bow before the Lord. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Go to the Lord for yourself. Hallelujah. Praise your name, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Lord, I pray for those that have come as they surrender what they're going through, oh God. We pray, oh Heavenly Father, that you would hear their cry. In the name of Jesus, as they surrender and know and recognize who you are, hallelujah. We give your name the praise today, Father God. We bless your name, Father. We say yes to your will. We say yes to your will, Lord. We say yes to your will. Thank you, Lord. With surrendered hearts, we bow before you, Lord. We lift up our loved ones to you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Have your way, oh God. Thank you, Jesus. We give your name the praise. Yes, Lord. We say yes to your will, oh God. Yes to your way, oh God. Thank you, Lord. Have your way, Lord. Touch the hearts of your people. Hear their cry, oh God. We give you the praise today, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Bless your name, oh God. Thank you, Lord. 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 We give your name the praise, God. Thank you, Lord. Thank you.
you, Lord. The Lord wants a surrendered mind and a surrendered spirit. He wants you to come before him. Come before him, he cried. Talk to me, he said. Surrender yourself to me. Surrender your thoughts to me. Surrender your love. Surrender it. Surrender. The Lord is calling for surrenderance. Surrender before the Lord. We thank you right now, Father God. We thank you right now, Father God. Have your way, oh God. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Have your way, oh God. Have your way, Lord. We bow down before you. Right now, Lord, we're praying for the young people, Lord God. They have different trials than what we have. Oh God, we pray that you would meet their need right now in Jesus' name. They're growing up in worship. They're growing up to praise you, Father God. We're teaching them the best that we know how. We're praying for the mother.
This is the time I'm going to talk to our social media, those that are watching that don't know Jesus. I always like to use the example of someone's put a gun to your back and you raise your hand. In other words, it's like total surrender. Today is the day of salvation. Today is the day you say yes to the Lord. When we worship God, we're in total surrender. That's why our hands are always up. Today is your day. The Lord allowed you to live another day. Don't put it off no more. The next moment is not promised to you. I can use our pet as an example. I've seen her alive 1 minute, not even knowing that she was going to pass away. All that morning, I'm just letting you know that you are alive and full of health. I heard yesterday that someone that my wife knew, husband and wife, they got up together. They had breakfast together. They walked together. And she went to get ready to go because she had somewhere to go. And the husband went in the room to lay down, and he didn't get back up. I'm not trying to scare you. I want you to know this is life. I don't know when the Lord's going to call my name. I don't know. I just praise God I accepted him as my personal Savior, because there's only one way to get to eternity. There's only one way to get to glory, and his name is Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ says, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. What I love about Jesus is he's an example of how we should live. And I praise God I got Jesus while I'm down here. This is a temporary location. We're not here. We're not supposed to be here forever. We get that twisted. We forget that at any moment, the Lord can call us home. I've seen people in their 50s pass away last week. 58 years old. I'm 61. I praise God for 61. The Lord allowed me to live to see 61 years a month ago today. You don't know how excited I was. I didn't need nothing. I had life. That was the biggest gift that I could ever have. Jesus says, I am come that you might have life and have it more abundantly. The Amplifier says, to the full until it overflows. I praise God for life today. And you have an opportunity to get your life right with the Lord Jesus Christ. Don't you see what's happening in the world today? Didn't you just hear the word that just went forth with power on today? So many examples, so powerful to remind us that it's time to say yes. She went into my message for next week, but that's good. Because that gives y'all an opportunity to know. I'm going to talk about being set apart next week. I'm going to talk about holiness next week. I get a chance to preach again. Woo! I've been on hiatus for a month. Praise God for the women of Greater Faith Christian Church. Hallelujah. Job well done. Glory to God. I love it when I can hear the word and it rings glory in my ears. I love that. Ooh, she might have been hard. I know how she feels. It's some Sundays when the Lord give me a word, I'm like, ooh, I got to say that. And he don't even respond. He don't have to respond. You better do what I say, is his response. Today is the day of salvation. Today, when you hear the Lord's voice, he's talking to you. He's talking to you. Everything else been working. You've been trying to work it. How's that working out for you? Oh, I know. I know. Been there, done that. Tried to live my life any kind of way I want to live it. And yeah, I'm going to be wrong. Like I always am. I had Jesus and still wanted to do what I want to do. How do you think the Lord felt? How do you think the Lord feels when before you were formed in my mother's womb, I knew you? He knows the very hairs on your head. Yeah, I got some up there. You just don't see it. He knows the very hairs on your head. He knows you. The plans that he has for you, he was the one that ordained it for you. He wants all of the glory. Don't stop taking credit for what God has done for you. He's knocking on your heart's door right now. There's no knob on the outside. It's on the inside. He wants you to open your heart's door and let him in. Those of you who have not given your life to the Lord Jesus Christ, are you ready? Are you ready to give your life to the Lord Jesus Christ? I know you are now. Okay, just repeat after me. It's real simple. Just say, Lord Jesus, here I am. I'm your child. You made me. Thank you, Lord, for not giving up on me. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord, for giving me a chance, for giving me another opportunity to give my life back to you. And now, Lord, I know you, God, and I know your son Jesus is the Savior of the world. Forgive me of my sins. Come into my heart. Use me for your glory. Let your light shine in me. I'll serve you the rest of my life. In the name of Jesus. Amen. Straight, simple, to the point, isn't it? Now, if you said that, now your name is written in the Lamb's Book of Life. What that mean? That mean when Jesus Christ comes back for us, because he's on his way back. That mean when he comes, cracking the sky, his feet won't touch the ground no more. He don't have to come back down there no more. Been there, done that. Sitting at the right hand of the throne of the Father, making intercessions and praying for us on our behalf, making intercessions. I love the Lord for that. When he comes back, when we all get together, what a day of rejoicing that will be. Hallelujah. I'm looking forward to that day. I am. I'm looking forward to that day. When I see Jesus, hallelujah, we will sing and shout the victory. Praise the Lord. Now, I'll celebrate with you right now. You're giving your life to the Lord Jesus Christ. If you're outside the state of Arizona, go find a church that preach and teach the word of God. If you can't, for wherever area you are, you can't get there, you can't drive, and you have access to the internet, we'll be more than happy to have you come and fellowship with us where you're doing it, or how you're doing it right now. YouTube, Facebook Live. We're working on our web page right now where when we come on live, all you have to do is go to our website so we can have that traffic going right there. Hopefully and prayerfully, it should be done soon. But in the meantime, go and try and walk and find a church to preach and teach the word of God. Assemble with the saints. That's what the word of God says. Oh, we have fellowship one with another. When you assemble with the saints, it's a powerful thing. Come on to God's house. But if you're here in the Valley of the Sun, we're in the West Valley between Bethany Home and Glendale Avenue off I-17. We'll be happy. Our information is right there. You see it? It's right there on the screen. We'll be more than happy to have you come and fellowship with us. Our Sunday school is at 9 a.m. We even have children's Sunday school at 9 a.m. as well. Bring your children. And we start at 10 o'clock a.m. sharp as we come and worship the Lord together. Looking forward to seeing you come and fellowship with us. We'll do all we can to support you. Again, our information is right there on the screen for you. Amen. God bless you in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Come on, give the Lord a hand praise one more time.
It's offering time in the house. Oh, y'all ready? All right. No one needs an envelope, right? Are you filling your envelopes out? Are they filled out? Yeah? All right. Glory to God. What an awesome, awesome worship experience. Amen. This is a time when everybody can participate. Everybody. Glory to God. Amen. All right, let's go ahead before the Lord. Raise your offerings. Father, we thank you, Lord, for this awesome worship experience, Father. We thank you that, Lord, now we can give in our tithes and offerings, Father. Woo! What a glorious day. Father, we thank you, woo, for what you've done and what you're continuing to do, Father. You own the cattle on a thousand hills. We know you own all things, Father. Woo! Bless those, Lord, right now that had to give and those that had not to give that they can give next time, Father. And those on social media, bless them, Lord, that they will give into the ministry also, Father. As we come, Lord, not of necessity or grudgingly, we come, Lord, with our hearts open to give to you, Father, back what you've given to us. And we thank you for it, and we love you as we give, as it goes from our hand into your hand, Father. Bless it. In the mighty and matchless name of Jesus, you may now give your tithes and offerings. First Lady has the machine for those who need the machine.
I pray that you are enjoying our services today. I am happy to bring you our announcements for this beautiful day on the Lord on Sunday, March 26, 2023. Our regularly scheduled services are as follows. Every Sunday morning, we have intercessory prayer at 8:30 a.m. via our new conference call line. Our Sunday school classes are at 9 a.m. here at the church and through our conference call line. Our morning worship starts at 10 a.m. here at the church or can be viewed live via our website, gfccaz.org, or Facebook Live or YouTube Live under the Greater Faith page. We have midweek services, prayer meetings, and Bible study every Wednesday night at 7 p.m. via our conference call line. The conference number and access code are as follows. Phone number 412-679-5145. Access code 100-7336-pound. Did you know that Greater Faith Christian Church have a children's Sunday school? In order to train up your child, bring them to Sunday school so you both can learn more about God's Word. It is essential for you and your child to receive biblical knowledge and apply it. Our Sunday school starts at 9 a.m. Celebrating our Greater Faith Christian birthdays, Shemayan Yusuri, March 21st. Hoping your day was filled with many blessings and love. Happy birthday. There are no anniversaries. We are having Passover service. The date is Saturday, April 8th at 1 p.m. If you plan to attend, please sign the list so we can get an account for the Passover feast. Please see Sister Tish. Celebrating our Lord on this beautiful day, our today's scripture is Joel 2:12-13. Even now, declares the Lord, return to me with all your heart, with fasting and weeping and mourning. Rend your heart and not your garment. Return to the Lord your God, for he is gracious and compassionate, slow to anger and abounding in love. And he relents from sending calamity. Amen. I pray you are blessed by our worship experience of today. May our Lord bless you and keep you.
Amen, amen. Has everyone had the opportunity to give? Huh? Okay. Stretch your hands towards the offering. Father, we thank you once again, Lord, for this time of giving, Father. We give into the kingdom, Lord. Increase it that there may be meat in your house, Lord. Lights on, electricity, just everything, Father. Thank you, AC. We love you, Father. We thank you once again, Father, as we give this in love to you, back to you, Father. Multiply. In Jesus' mighty and matchless name I pray. Amen.
Amen. We're going to have to learn that song. We're going to have to learn this one right here. It's very simple, so they better get it. The day will be the best day of our life. Now, hey, Shemaya, I want you to tell everybody, how do you pronounce your name? Regina, all the way in Indiana, doing our announcement, so that's why it's kind of sounded the way it did. But praise the Lord for it.
It's Shymaine Usiri. Everybody calls me Shy, so that might be easier.
Shymaine, so we call her Shy. She said, it's all right if we call you Shy. Shymaine, you had a birthday on the 21st, girl. Bless the Lord. Bless the Lord. Did you sing happy birthday to mama on her birthday? You did? What type of cake she had? Was it good? Oh, did we? Something different. Ain't nothing wrong with that. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, Miss Shymaine. Happy birthday. Anybody else got a birthday? Who? On the 15th? Oh, that's right, because you weren't even here for me to serenade you. Happy birthday. We're out there on them big old hot air balloons. I saw you. So the Will Sutherland as well with Miss Shy. One, two, three. Happy birthday. Hey. Come on, let's serenade them. Come on. Sister, happy birthday, Will. May God bless both of y'all with many, 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 many more birthdays in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. I pray that this year will be the best year y'all ever had in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Just receive it and then just let me know what the Lord did for y'all this year, all right? I'm looking forward to seeing it if I'm still here. Praise the Lord. Glory to God. I did not open the doors of the church to see if anybody want to be family officially. If y'all want to be family officially, come on up here. Those are not even family that want to be family, come on up here, and we will become one in Christ as one body in the name of Jesus. If not, we're standing. Praise the Lord. God bless you all. Minister Diana Kurtz. We praise God for you this morning. Beautiful word, beautiful presentation before your word. That made a lot of sense, all that baggage you brought in here. That was good. That was good. It's like she said, a lot of us bring baggage to God's house. The sad thing about the baggage, that y'all keep the baggage on y'all so much that y'all don't worship God, y'all don't raise y'all hands, y'all just steal like this. How in the world can you surrender like this? You know, yeah, like she said, it's too heavy. The burden is too heavy. But I like that scripture verse that says to cast all of your cares. Not some of them. Not when you feel like giving him one.
Well.
Cast them all. You know what? And I'm done. When I come in God's house, I may, Miss Brown, be so upset outside that door. But when I come in God's house, I got no sense to know how to reverence the house of God. I know why I'm supposed to come to God's house. And everything that I got going on inside of me, I leave it right outside that door. And a lot of people don't know how to do that. But the more they hear it, when they come and assemble themselves together, the better they know when whatever our problem is. I was just in the car arguing with my wife. When you come into God's house, and by the time church is over, baby, yeah, forget all about it, right? That's what I want us to do. Get into that mind frame. And so y'all can enjoy the rest of y'all day, which I know you all will today. The beautiful worship experience. So glad to see each and every one of y'all again. Sister went out to feed little man. I said, you ain't got to go to the car. She said, it's easier for me to go to the car. I said, no, anywhere in the back there, because that room there is for the babies. We'll know. That's why he's there with his grandchild. And even our overflow area back here. And when it gets too full, I'm just going to open up the fellowship hall in the back so you can go back there as well. Amen? Amen. Amen. God bless you all. Come on.
More prayer? More power.
More power.
Less prayer? Less power. Woo! Thank you, Father, for this awesome worship experience, God, that we participated in, God. We gave you the glory. Father, as we depart from this place, but never your face, Lord. Go with us, be with us, guide us, and lead us. May we be your word, eat your word, and live your word before this dying word, world, Lord. Give us traveling grace and mercy, God, over the highways and byways, Lord. Thank you once again, Father, for everything you've done and everything you're continuing to do. In the mighty and matchless name of Jesus, I pray, amen, and have a beautiful week. God bless you.